I'm Grace Burrell and you're watching The 86th Floor. We've just seen Avengers Age of Ultron at the London IMAX and my God, sorry, that should be my gosh, Captain America, what an experience. This is an instantaneous spoiler-free review, so we're going to skip
doing a big synopsis and just share with you what we thought was good, great, and what maybe didn't work that well. So what was good? The script was pretty good. It was plucky and humorous, especially the dialogue between Tony Stark and the other characters, particularly Captain America, who, by the way, seems to have lightened up a bit. Nick Fury and Rhodey also have a few great lines. 80% of the time, the gags were spot on, but I'd say the other 20% were a bit forced and repetitive, and sometimes a bit too diffusive in times of tension. Age of Ultron really explored each character in more depth than we've previously seen. We got to learn about their backstory and fears, and this was particularly poignant in Black Widow's case. Oh, and for the record, anyone who thought Black Widow and Hawkeye didn't have much to offer the Avengers team, you are wrong, and the first 15 minutes of the movie proves it. End of. So what was great? The action scenes were great. Of course they were. They didn't disappoint. The very first scene where the Avengers break into a Hydra post in the fictional Eastern European region of Slovakia was fantastic and set the tone for the film as a whole. The pace was relentless and we got around four major action scenes in what didn't feel like a particularly long movie. If you get the chance, we really recommend watching it in 3D as it made it awesome and I felt like an actual Avenger. Hulk and Iron Man have some particularly immense battles together and Thor really came into his own and picked himself up after the slightly disappointing Thor Dark World movie. But he is now well and truly back on form. Another great thing about Age of Ultron was the score, which was composed by Brian Tyler and Danny Elfman. There were call-outs to other Avenger movies, as well as the rest of the Marvel Universe, so that was really superbly done. And the final great thing that deserves a mention is the hammer reveal, but we won't say too much about that, except that someone, other than Thor, manages to pick up the Mjolnir. So what maybe didn't work that well? Well, the main event in this movie is Stark's creation of the Avengers' nemesis, Ultron, who then tries to kill the world by recreating his own meteor strike. We had a few ums and ahs about Ultron. He was a great villain, but we weren't really told why he chose to be so evil as soon as he was created. It didn't seem to be questioned by anyone, and we could have done with a bit more explanation there. Although, come on, Tony. If you call a robot Ultron, the odds are it's probably going to turn out evil. Maybe next time pick a prettier name, like, say, Jocasta. A further small issue we had was with Vision's whole image. It basically was just Paul Bettany in a morph suit wearing a cloak that looked suspiciously like Thor's. A bit more creativity wouldn't have gone amiss here, although his human features provided a really great contrast to Ultron's crazy metal bodywork, especially at the end of the movie. And finally, why doesn't Hawkeye ever run out of arrows? Does anyone have a theory behind this? Let us know in the comments below and we'd love to hear your opinion of Avengers Age of Ultron. Also, if you feel like you need to catch up with everything that's happened in the Marvel Cinematic Universe so far to bring you up to speed before watching this, check out Anime K's Marvel Universe Epic Recap, which you can watch right here. See you next time.
Hanging out in Alpha Centauri, Loki made friends with the Chitauri. He said to them, make me a deal, give me an army and the earth I'll steal.